Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm IDE in Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install PyCharm IDE, you need to first download PyCharm itself. So for that, all you need to do is you need to just simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply type PyCharm download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this www.jetbrains.com. So just simply click on this download PyCharm, and this will going to redirect you to this official site of JetBrains. In here, if you just simply scroll down a bit, you can clearly see the latest version that they have released is on 15th of September 2021, right? And currently we are going to install it for Windows. So this Windows tab has been rightly selected. If you are using macOS or Linux, then you need to just simply proceed with these tabs. Since I am installing it for Windows, so just simply click on this Windows, and you can see we have these two options. One is professional, another is the community one. Now the community one is totally free, so we are going to proceed with this community one. If you want to download professional one, then you can easily download it. Free trial is also available, right? So that's totally your choice. I'm going to show you in this video how to download PyCharm community version. So just simply click on this download button, and it will going to start downloading our PyCharm, right? Since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see the latest version of PyCharm, that is PyCharm Community 2021.2.2, has been rightly downloaded over here. So all you need to do is you need to just simply double click on it to basically start installing our PyCharm IDE. And you can clearly see our PyCharm installation has been rightly open. So just simply minimize our download directory. And this will going to ask you for administrative privileges. So for that, just simply click on yes. And you can clearly see welcome to PyCharm community edition setup. So this is basically the installation setup. So just simply click on next. And this is going to be our destination folder. So if you want to change your destination folder, you can always click on browse and you can do that. But I'm going to keep everything as a default. So just simply click on next. And now under this installation options, they are giving some options. So I'm going to recommend you to check this PyCharm community edition, right? So that a desktop shortcut gets created over here, like the Intel IG IDE. You can see this a PyCharm desktop shortcut is going to be created, right? And then I would also like to check this add open folder as project, so you can easily right click on any project and you can just open that folder as a project, right? And I'd also like to check this .py so that this all Python related files I can easily open using PyCharm, right? And I would also like to check this add bin folder to path. This is a very important step, guys. Do check that. This is very important to set the environment path right during the installation. So do check that. And then just simply click on next. And now it's ready to be installed. So just simply click on install. And you can clearly see our installation has been rightly begun. And you can also see that our PyCharm community edition desktop shortcut link has also been created over here, right? So you can just simply double click on it and you can open that. So I'll show you that, and it will going to take some time to install. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing PyCharm IDE. Yeah, so we'll come back. And now you can clearly see our PyCharm community edition setup has been rightly installed, and it's currently telling that whether you'd like to reboot now or you want to reboot manually later. So it's always recommended to reboot your system now. So for that, just simply check this, and then you need to just simply click on finish so that the reboot process can get started. So again, this will take a couple of minutes. So what we'll be doing is I'll be coming back after rebooting my machine. So welcome back. So now after successfully rebooting your system, you will be getting this PyCharm community edition desktop shortcut has been rightly created in your desktop. So just simply double click on it to basically start our PyCharm community edition. And you can clearly see our PyCharm community edition has been rightly opened. So it is currently launching. So welcome to PyCharm. So let us first maximize it. All right, and you can see that latest version of PyCharm, that is 2021.2.2, has been rightly opened over here. So welcome to PyCharm. Now you can always click on start tour, and you can, you know, tour this entire PyCharm, but I am not going to, you know, take that much amount of time. So I am going to right now show you how you can easily run Hello World Python program in your PyCharm IDE. So for that, all you need to do is, you know, to just simply create a new project. So just, you know, simply click on this plus icon, and this will, you know, going to open this new project window. In here, you need to give a project name. So let's give a project name as a Hello Everyone, right? And keep everything as default, right? And then just, you know, simply click on create. And this is going to start preparing our project, and you can clearly see it is currently, you know, showing the tip of the day. So just, you know, simply close it, and it is also downloading our Python, right? So it is not mandatory to install Python before installing PyCharm IDE, right? So you can always install your Python directly after, you know, installing PyCharm IDE. And all you need to do is, you need to just simply click on yes to give permission for admin so that they can install Python. So again, this will take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing Python. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see our Python has been rightly installed, along with our PyCharm has been rightly also opened this Hello Everyone project. So just, you know, simply click expand it, and they have also created this main.py file, right? So here all you need to do is, you need to just, you know, simply click on this run button so that this hi PyCharm gets printed. So you can see this hi PyCharm gets printed over here. So how it is getting printed is by, you know, they have declared this, you know, print hi as a method, and they are calling it from this main function over here. So this print hi is actually getting called from here, right? And they are passing this PyCharm as a parameter, which is, you know, getting received in this name variable, and they are going to print this hi, then this PyCharm that they are getting from this parameter, right? Hi PyCharm. So if you change it to, you know, hi, let's say Geeky Script, and if you just simply click on this run button, you can see hi Geeky Script is getting printed over here, right? So in this way, you can easily install PyCharm IDE along with Python in your industrial operating system, right? And you can do several other operations in Python, like, you know, let's say you want to print something, like you want to, let's say you want to do some addition. So if you assign it variable A as 5 and variable B as 2, let's say, and you want to, you know, print basically multiplication of these two values. So all you need to do is, you need to just, you know, simply A into B, and if you just simply click on this run button, you can see this multiplication of these two variables, that is A into B, is 10, that is basically showing, right? Along with this hi Geeky Script and all is also showing, because we are calling it from this main method, right? So in this way, you can easily install the latest version of PyCharm IDE along with Python in Windows 10 operating system, right? So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and so do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.